Hi students, in the last class I have discussed about formation of measles, mechanism of formation of measles. I had explained measles are nothing but associated colloids. What are the examples for associated colloids? Soaps and detergents. Soap, general formula. What is the general formula for soap? Soap general formula is RCOO minus Na plus. So generally soaps are the sodium or potassium salts of long chain fatty acids. For this example, sodium stearate. What is the formula for sodium stearate? CH3, CH2 taken 16, COO minus Na plus. This is sodium stearate. Sodium stearate. Similarly, for detergent, what is the formula for detergent? Detergent formula is RSO3 minus Na plus. Of course, different detergents are there, cationic, anionic, and neutral detergents. This is the general formula for cationic detergent. For this example is CH3, CH2 taken 11, SO3 minus Na plus. This is sodium lauryl sulfate. Sodium lauryl sulfate. Sodium lauryl sulfate. That is the general formula for detergent. This is the general formula for soap. So here let's see the cleansing action of soap. It is some dirty surface on which some grease is deposited. Dirty surface with grease or oil or fat. So what happens when it is dipped in water, and to that some soap is added, what happens? The soap molecules, I said earlier that soap molecules are represented in this way. This is head of soap, which is hydrophilic. This is tail of soap, which is hydrophobic. Hydrophilic attracts water, whereas hydrophobic repels water. That's why, what is the correct place for the soap ions? Soap ions in water? Yes, at the surface. At the surface, the anions of soap fit at the surface. How? In this hydrophilic end lies inside water. Whereas hydrophobic ends, they are projected away from the water surface in that way. So when the soap solution is added to dirty surface, what happens? This is the oil droplet or fat or some grease on the dirty surface. Oil on surface it is. So to this, when soap solution is added, what happens? The soap molecules, see here, in this way, soap molecules are attracted by this dirty surface, because you know hydrocarbon part attracts oil or fat, because hydrophobic means it is non-polar part, that's why it attracts the non-polar solvent, non-polar compound. So fat or oil is a non-polar. That's why in this, what happens is all the soap ions, soap RCOO minus Na plus, na, it is when dissolved in water, it dissociates into ions to give soap anion plus cation. These anions, in this way, what happens? They are attracted by oil or fat. So ultimately, they break the oil droplet. They break the oil droplet to form, this is oil droplet, So in this way, they collect oil droplet as nozzle. This is nozzle with ionic nozzle with oil droplet, oil drop at the interior. So why? These are hydrophobic, tail part is hydrophobic, so that dissolves in oil or fat. So when the concentration of soap in that solution exceeds its CMC, critical measure concentration, then measles are formed. These measles bind the oil droplet at their interior part. Because here negative charge na here hydrophilic ends, these hydrophilic ends may interact with water. That's why these hydrophilic ends take away these oil droplet into solution from the dirty surface as a small droplets oil or grease or fat is removed in the form of measles. So they can interact with water, that's why they are washed away and they are cleaned away from the dirty surface. Okay, so in that way, as measles, the oil or fat that is added on the cloth or any crockery is removed. Okay, here there is no aggregation of these measles again. Why? There is a sheath of negative charges at the surface of measles. That's why two measles do not come into contact, because each measle is having a negative charge on its surface. That's why they do not come into contact. If they come into contact, what happens? Aggregation takes place. Because of that, simply they settle down. So that will not happen. So each measle takes away an oil droplet or fat drop along with it. In that way, that dirty surface is cleaned. So this is cleansing action of soap. In the same way, we have discussed now cleansing action of soap. In the same way, we can discuss the cleansing action of detergent also. In the detergent, see, for example, this sodium lauryl sulfate. In this sodium lauryl sulfate, what is the hydrophilic end? SO3 minus is hydrophilic end. This part, CH3, CH2, 11, it is the hydrophobic end. Though this hydrophobic end dissolves in fat or dirt, fat or oil or grease, whatever it may be. So in that this hydrophobic end dissolves and hydrophilic end lies at the surface. So when the concentration is crossing certain minimum value, this oil is broken into small droplets, and those small droplets are taken away by the measles. These are being polar at the interface. See, there are negative charge, na? They can interact with water, na? That's why they take away the oil droplets along with them. So in that way, dirty surface can be cleaned.